Now the next example prove that j transform of a raised to k upon k factorial equal to e raised to a by z, where k is greater than or equal to 0. So note that here divide by k factorial. So here is solution. By definition of z transform of f of k equal to summation, k varies from minus infinity to infinity, f of k into z raised to minus k. Now note here k is greater than or equal to 0. And f of k, if we compare, so I am getting here, it is a raised to k upon k factorial. And that is why z transform of a raised to k upon k factorial, and that is equal to summation, k varies from 0 to infinity, because here k is greater than or equal to 0. A raised to k upon k factorial into z raised to minus k. Now due to factorial, I can write this as a summation, means it is a series. How? Summation k varies from 0 to infinity. So here, this part I can write as a by z raised to k. So a by z raised to k upon k factorial. And if we put here k equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. So I am getting one standard series. What is that? So I am getting k equal to 0. So it is a 1 upon 1 plus k is 1. So a by z upon 1 factorial plus a by z square upon 2 factorial plus a by z cube upon 3 factorial plus a by z raised to 4 upon 4 factorial plus and so on. It means that it is a 1 plus a by z upon 1 factorial plus a by z square upon 2 factorial plus a by z cube upon 3 factorial plus a by z raised to 4 upon 4 factorial and so on. So it is a standard series. So which is that standard series? So by using the standard series, so here e raised to x. So since standard series e raised to x. So if we compare, so I am getting z transform of a raised to k upon k factorial equal to, it is a 1 plus x, x square by 2 factorial. So if we compare, so I am getting x equal to a by z. And therefore, it is a e raised to a by z. So which is our required result. So hence proof. Now the next example, find z transform of f of k equal to sin 3k plus 4, where k is greater than or equal to 0. So you can observe here, it contains sin, and you already have table of standard sequence, means z transform of standard sequence. So here sin, so what is that table? So by using this table, you can use here sin alpha k formula. So solution, given f of k equal to sin 3k plus 4. So we have formula for z transform sin alpha k, but here alpha k plus something. So you have to use sin a plus b formula first. So what is that formula? Since sin a plus b equal to sin a into cos b plus cos a into sin b. And that is why I am getting f of k equal to sin 3k into cos 4 plus cos 3k into sin 4. Note that here cos 4 and sin 4 are constant now. It not contains k. And as we know, by using the table of z transform of standard sequence. So as we know, by the table of z transform, here the standard f of k means sequence are cos alpha k, sin alpha k. So you can use that. So since by using standard z transform of alpha k, where k is greater than or equal to 0, is z into z minus cos alpha upon z square minus 2z cos alpha plus 1, and z transform of sin alpha k, where k is greater than or equal to 0, is z sin alpha upon z square minus 2z cos alpha plus 1. If we compare here, sin 3k एंड हियर साइन अल्फा के. व्हाट इज अल्फा हियर? अल्फा इक्वल टू 3. एंड इफ कॉस अल्फा के एंड हियर कॉस 3 के, सो हियर ऑल्सो अल्फा इक्वल टू 3. सो बाय यूजिंग दिस स्टैंडर्ड जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म आई कैन राइट डायरेक्टली. सो जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ साइन 3k प्लस 4 दैट इज इक्वल टू जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ साइन 3k इंटू कॉस 4 प्लस कॉस 3k इंटू साइन 4. बाय लीनियरिटी प्रॉपर्टी यू कैन कंसिडर दिस सेपरेट, दैट इज द कॉस 4 कॉन्स्टेंट इंटू जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ साइन 3k प्लस साइन 4 कॉन्स्टेंट एंड जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ कॉस 3k. सो बाय यूजिंग दिस टू वी कैन राइट डायरेक्टली जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ साइन 3k प्लस 4 दैट इज इक्वल टू हियर कॉस 4 कॉन्स्टेंट एंड जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ साइन 3k एंड दैट इज नथिंग बट जेड इंटू साइन अल्फा. सो जेड इंटू साइन 3 बिकॉज अल्फा इक्वल टू 3 हियर अपॉन जेड स्क्वेयर माइनस 2z cos alpha means cos 3 plus 1 plus sin 4 constant and z transform of cos 3k is nothing but z into z minus cos alpha means cos 3 upon z square minus 2z cos 3 plus 1. Note that here in both case mod of z is greater than 1. So now simplify it. So I am getting z into cos 4 sin 3 अपॉन जेड स्क्वेयर माइनस 2z cos 3 प्लस 1 प्लस. सो हियर इफ यू सिंप्लीफाई आई एम गेटिंग जेड इंटू साइन 4 इंटू जेड माइनस cos 3 होल डिवाइड्स जेड स्क्वेयर माइनस 2z cos 3 प्लस 1. यू कैन ऑब्जर्व हियर द डिनोमिनेटर इज सेम, दैट इज वाई बाय सिंप्लीफिकेशन आई एम गेटिंग हियर एलसीएम इज सेम मीन्स z square minus 2z cos 3 plus 1 and in numerator z into cos 4 sin 3 plus, now you multiply inside this one, so I am getting z square sin 4 minus z into sin 4 cos 3. So this is your z transform of sin 3k plus 4. One may simplify more, how? Let's see here. So z transform of sin 3k plus 4 equal to, so this term you write first, so I am getting z square sin 4 and from this 2, this one and this one, I can common out minus z, so I am getting minus z common, so this first, so what is remaining, sin 4 cos 3 minus, because here minus z common, that is why minus. And I am getting cos 4 into sin 3. Whole divides z square minus 2z cos 3 plus 1. So what I am getting? Z transform of sin 3k plus 4 equal to z square sin 4 minus z. So now you can observe here. What is this formula? Sin A into cos B minus cos A into sin B. As we know, sin a minus b equal to sin a into cos b minus cos a into sin b. So if we compare both the things, so I can get here a is 4 and b is 3, and that is why I am getting here sin 4 minus 3. Student can write it directly upon z square minus 2z cos 3 plus 1. Now simplify and you will get the final answer, that is a z transform of sin 3k plus 4 that is equal to z square sin 4 minus z sin 1 whole divides z square minus 2z cos 3 plus 1, which is your required answer. Note that here, what is the condition? Condition is mod of z is greater than 1, so which is your required. So example, find z transform of f of k equal to 2 raised to k plus 1 where k is greater than or equal to 0 and 3 raised to k plus 1 when k is less than 0. So this is very interesting and new type. So how? So by definition only you can prove it, or you can find the z transform of the f of k. So what is the given thing? So f of k equal to 2 raised to k plus 1 when k is greater than or equal to 0 and 3 raised to k plus 1 when k is less than 0, strictly less than 0, note that. So we can find Z transform of this f of k means this sequence by two methods. One is by using directly table means standard values or standard Z transform, and second by definition. So one by one. So first method by standard Z transform. So how? So this is the table of Z transform. So here A raised to k when k is greater than or equal to 0 and A raised to k when k is less than 0. So we can use this thing. How? Let's see. So for method 1, I am using this one. Okay, so for our reference, I am just keeping here. And that is why I am getting the Z transform of f of k equal to. Now, I can consider it is a Z transform of 2 raised to k plus 1 plus Z transform of 3 raised to k plus 1. How? Here, k is greater than or equal to 0 and here k is less than 0. So, same thing I can write as it is a 2 into 2 raised to k, here 2 constant, plus Z transform of here also 3 into 3 raised to k, because here 2 raised to k plus 1 I can write as a 2 into 2 raised to k. Similarly for 3 raised to k plus 1. And don't forget here k is greater than or equal to 0, k is less than 0 or strictly less than 0. So when k is greater than or equal to 0, a raised to k is nothing but z upon z minus a. And that is why I am getting here, it is a 2 outside and z transform of 2 raised to k plus 3 outside because it is a constant. Z transform of 3 raised to k. So here k is greater than or equal to 0, here k is less than 0. So greater than or equal to 0 means this formula I can use, and which is nothing but z upon. So 2 constant as it is. So z upon z minus a. So z minus 2 here because a raised to k, here 2 raised to k. So a is 2 plus 3 into. Now, Z transform of 3 raised to k when k is strictly less than 0. So, this formula I can use, and I am getting it is a Z upon A minus Z means 3 minus Z. Note that in the first case, mod of Z is greater than mod of A, and in second case, mod of Z is less than mod of A. Means here, what is value of A in the first term? The value of A is 2 and in second value of A is 3. So, I am getting mod of 3. So, definitely 3 is a positive. So, need not to consider mod for that. The same thing I can write here, that is the Z transform of given f of k equal to 2z upon z minus 2 plus 3z upon 3 minus z, where mod of z, note that here, mod of z is greater than 2 and mod of z is less than 3. The same thing I can write as which is a least here 2. So that is why 2 is less than mod of z and which is less than 3. So which is our required answer. So this is a method number 1. If I know the standard z transform of a raised to k when k is greater than or equal to 0 and k is less than 0. Second method there by using definition. So how? Let's see. So by definition of Z transform. Z transform of f of k equal to. So by definition we know it is a summation k varies from minus infinity to infinity f of k z raised to minus k. Note that here given sequence where k is greater than or equal to 0 means 0 to infinity and less than 0 means minus 1 to minus infinity. So, I will split this summation in two parts like this. Here summation k varies from minus infinity to minus 1 f of k z raised to minus k plus summation k varies from 0 to infinity where f of k into z raised to minus k. In the given sequence f of k when k is minus 1 to minus infinity means here k is strictly less than 0. What I am getting? It is nothing but 3:2 strictly less than 0, 3:k+1 and greater than or equal to 0, 2:k+1. And that is why I am getting here summation k varies from minus infinity to minus 1. Here 3:k+1, z^-k, and for the 0 to infinity, what is f of k? It is a 2:k+1 into z^-k. And now I can write here same thing as a summation k varies from minus infinity to minus 1. Here 3:k+1, I can write 3 × 3:k, z^-k, plus summation k varies from 0 to infinity, 2 × 2:k into z^-k. Note that here we have direct formula since r^k, where k equal to 1 to infinity and k equal to 0 to infinity. It means that here this negative sign I want to convert into positive. How? So in the first term of right hand side, just convert into positive. So how? So put k equal to minus m, and therefore minus k equal to plus m. And if we consider here, the k varies from minus 1 to minus infinity. Note that here summation from minus infinity to minus 1 or minus 1 to minus infinity, summation is same. Just like 1 + 2 + 3, I can write 3 + 2 + 1. So it becomes m equal to 1 to infinity, and that is why this z transform of f of k, it becomes now summation m varies from 1 to infinity, 3 constant, 3:k, k is what now? Minus m, and z^-k means it is m, plus second as it is, so summation k varies from 0 to infinity, 2 constant, 2:k, and z^-k. So just write this part and this part in the form of r^k. So how? So I am getting that is equal to 3 constant outside, summation m varies from 1 to infinity, and this is z/3 / m. Note that here this is power negative, so it is in denominator, it will be positive m. And I can consider z/3 / m. So plus 2 here constant outside. So summation k varies from 0 to infinity. Here 2/z/k. Be careful about 2 and z. Here 2 and here z. So again the same thing, that is here. So 1 to infinity means this formula r/(1 − r). So here r means z/3. So z/3 / 1 − r means z/3. Plus 2, k varies from 0 to infinity. So 1/(1 − r). So I am getting 1/(1 − r) means 2/z. Note that for the first, mod of r is less than 1. Mod of r is less than 1. So in the first term, I am getting mod of z/3 is less than 1, and in second term mod of 2/z is less than 1, and therefore z transform of f of k equal to, so now here multiply numerator and denominator by 3, so I am getting, so 3 constant and as it is, so multiply by 3, so I am getting z/3 − z plus 2. Here multiply by z, numerator and denominator. So I am getting z/(z − 2). So same thing I can write as, but before to that, here mod of z is less than 3, and mod of 2 means it is a 2 less than mod of z, because 3 and 2 are positive values. So need not to consider mod there, and that is why z transform of f of k equal to 3z/3 − z plus 2z/(z − 2). Note that here 2 is less than mod z. So same thing I can write as 2 is less than mod z, and mod z is less than 3, which is your final answer, required answer, z transform of f of k. So by method 2. So what is in method 1? 2z/(z − 2), 2z by z minus 2. Yes, it is there. And plus 3z by 3 minus z. So 3z by 3 minus z. 2 is less than mod z is less than 3. So there also 2 is less than mod of z is less than 3. It means that same answer, which is your required answer. So note the both method. So normally first method, that is you have to remember the table. But if you don't know the table, so direct by definition also you can find z transform f of k. So note this case. Yes, this is your final answer. But one may simplify more. That is the z transform of f of k equal to, if we take a LCM of both, it is a 3 minus z into z minus 2. So here 3z into z minus 2 plus 2z into 3 minus z. So simplified. So I am getting that is equal to 3z square minus 6z plus 6z minus 2z square. Whole divides 3 minus z and z minus 2. That is equal to, so 3z square minus 2z square, it becomes now z square upon, this get cancelled here, z minus 2 and 3 minus z. Condition is same, that is nothing but a 2 is less than mod of z is less than 3. So this is your z transform of f of k after simplification. So now the new example, find the z transform of f of k equal to 4 into 3 raised to k plus 1 plus 5 into 4 raised to k plus 1, where k is greater than or equal to 0. So solution given, f of k equal to 4 into 3 raised to k plus 1 plus 5 into 4 raised to k plus 1, where k is greater than or equal to 0. So same thing I can write as in the form of raised to k. So as 4 into, so here 3 raised to k plus 1, I can write 3 into 3 raised to k plus 5 into 4 raised to k plus 1, I can write 4 into 4 raised to k. Here k is greater than or equal to 0. So that is why f of k equal to this 3 outside. So I am getting it is the 12 into 3 raised to k plus 20. 5 into 4, it is a 20 into 4 raised to k. So what is the z transform of this? So z transform of f of k is nothing but z transform of 12 into 3 raised to k plus 20 into 4 raised to k, where k is greater than or equal to 0. So same thing I can write by using linearity property. So it is a 12 constant into z transform of 3 raised to k plus 20 constant into z transform of 4 raised to k. And don't forget here k is greater than or equal to 0. Again here two methods, that is one is by direct standard z transform and second by using a definition. So by using this standard z transform, a raised to k, k is greater than or equal to 0. The z transform is z upon z minus a, where mod of z is greater than a. So you can use this one. So since z transform of a, where k is greater than or equal to 0, a raised to k, I can use here. And that is why I am getting z transform of f of k equal to this 12 constant and z transform 3 raised to k. Means here a is 3. And therefore it is nothing but z upon z minus 3 plus 20 into 4 raised to k, means here a equal to 4. So z upon z minus 4. Note that in the first, mod of z is greater than mod of 3, means simply 3. And in second, mod of z is greater than mod of 4, means simply 4. Now simplify here. What is LCM? It is a z minus 3 into z minus 4, this 12z into z minus 4 plus 20z into z minus 3. So simplified. So I am getting here 12z square minus 48z plus 20z square minus 60z. Whole divides z minus 3 into z minus 4. Note that here it mod of z is greater than 4 and 4 is greater than 3. So simply I can write it is a mod of z is greater than 4. If we consider here supposed to be it is a 3 and it's a 4. So greater than 3 means like this and greater than 4 means this one. So if we consider only greater than 4, so automatically it is a greater than 3. So now simplify it. So I am getting z transform of f of k equal to, so 12 plus 20, it is 32, z square minus 48 and 60, 108 z, whole divides, z minus 3, z minus 4. So we can common out 4z. So in bracket I am getting 8z minus 27, z minus 3 into z minus 4. It is a z transform of f of k, which is your final answer. Don't forget here mod of z is greater than 4. So here is one example. Find z transform of f of k equal to minus into minus 1 by 3 raised to k when k is less than 0 and equal to minus 1 by 4 raised to k where k is greater than or equal to 0. So very simple way we can find it. So solution, given f of k, you write as it is, and here z transform of f of k equal to z transform of first part. What is that? It is a minus into minus 1 by 3 raised to k where k is less than 0, strictly less than 0, plus z transform of minus 1 by 4 raised to k where k is greater than or equal to 0. Note that here again by using table of z transform, here the condition a raised to k is greater than or equal to 0 and strictly less than 0. So by using these two we can find the z transform of given f of k easily. Since we have these two standard z transform, I can write z transform of f of k equal to this minus sign you take outside and a raised to k is less than 0. So this formula. So what is a here? If we compare, so a is nothing but minus 1 by 3. So I am getting it is a z upon a minus a z. So minus 1 by 3 minus a z plus z transform of a raised to k where k is greater than or equal to 0 means this formula here a equal to minus 1 by 4. So it is nothing but a z upon z minus a is minus 1 by 4. Note that here in the first case k is less than 0 means this one here mod of z is less than mod of a is what here? It is a minus 1 by 3. So mod of this one. And in the second, mod of z means k is greater than or equal to 0. Mod of z is greater than mod of a means minus 1 by 4, but mod. So mod of z is greater than mod of minus 1 by 4. Okay, simplify it. And therefore, z transform of f of k, if we simplify it, I am getting this minus sign, you adjust inside. So I am getting this minus sign you adjust inside. So that is why I am getting z upon 1 by 3 plus z upon z minus minus plus 1 by 4. And here I am getting mod of z is less than 1 by 3 and mod of z is greater than 1 by 4. So this is your z transform of f of k, but one may simplify more. How? Let's see here. Z transform of f of k equal to, so here in numerator and denominator multiply by 3, so I am getting here 3z upon 1 plus 3z plus and here by 4, so multiply by 4 numerator and denominator, so I am getting 4z upon 4z plus 1 and here mod of z is less than 1 by 3 and mod of z is greater than 1 by 4. The same thing I can write as 1 by 4 is less than mod of z is less than 1 by 3 because same thing I can write as 1 by 4 is less than mod of 0. So simplify it, take a LCM. So what is the LCM here? Here 1 plus 3z and 4z plus 1. It means that it is a 3z plus 1 and a 4z plus 1. And it is a 3z into 4z plus 1 plus 4z into 3z plus 1. Because this 1 plus 3z, I can write 3z plus 1. Condition is same. So simplify it. So it is nothing but it is a 12z square plus 3z plus 12z square plus 4z. Whole divides 3z plus 1 into 4z plus 1. And therefore, the transform of f of k equal to 12 plus 12, it is a 24z square plus 3 plus 4, it is a 7z. Whole divides 3z plus 1 and 4z plus 1. Condition is 1 by 4 is less than mod of z is less than 1 by 3. So, if possible, you common out. So, I am getting z transform of f of k, z common. So, it is a 24z plus 7 whole divides 3z plus 1 into 4z plus 1. Condition is same, that is 1 by 4 is less than mod of z is less than 1 by 3, which is your required. So, required z transform of f of k.